So I'm making a video of this new to me 1942 Chevrolet military truck. Shaft, your intermediate shaft, your power takeoff, and then the winch as well. Look how the pumpkin's really high up. And then here goes here. Pump, hydraulics. I think that chain probably keeps it from tipping over too far. Somebody put an electric fuel pump on. And the hose. This is your, oh, there's a little hanger bearing there. Oh. Okay, that's not your, oh, master cylinder up there. There's your little transfer case. I like the green paint. Shock absorbers. Rubber, still in good shape. And there's the big cylinder up there. These brake lines are toast. We'll fix those. And there's a big spring there leading to this hitch. It's like these overloads are touching already. Alright. Wonder if it's a 3 or 4 speed. Turns good, nice. Speed out cable coming off the transfer case and all the shifters. Oh yeah, so our neutral. It's just simple and good. Simple and good. That's what it is. Simple and good. actual. Clevis thing there. And this little weak ball joint. That's a hell of a big tie rod. And notice how it's behind the axle. That's cool. Won't get banged up or dented. I need a lot of clearance between that axle and that winch shaft, but I guess it clears. Anyway, let's take a look. About this the most, folks, is look at the crankshaft. Turns. GM. Rochester. Somebody put an alternator in. Trying to find the dipstick. Where would that be? Oh, it's missing. It's right over there. There's a hole. Right there's the missing hole. Right there. Okay, we'll find a dipstick for this thing. I like how they put the rubber grommets through there. Like that. That's cool. This engine's just gonna purr. Heavy duty battery box, heated core, ground cable to the hood. Why would they do that? I like the greasability about this thing though. There's greaserks there, there, greaserk there, greaserk there, greaserk there, there, there. There. Down there. Bust it off there. Pretty much every universal joint. The rear one suspension there. Anyway, gotta say that's even pretty stylish. It goes up to 100. It's like, wow, really? It's original wood there. It's all wet in here because I had to wash it to get it across the border. Birds made nests in there, or squirrels or mice, which caused that to rot out. And that's just rot. Caused the back to rot out. That's kind of cool. Sheesh. You guys got an idea. I'm gonna call it a wrap.